Who here has heard about the risks around AI having to do with bias? All right, that's reassuring. I'm glad the word's getting out. So we see these moments where some company has released some cool new innovation in AI, and then a little while later, there's kind of uncomfortable flop. There's some moment where some image comes out, some words, some decision comes out from the AI that's like, whoa, okay, wait, we didn't mean that. And it's causing this really cool conversation to happen around mitigating bias in AI. And what can we do? Do we have options there? How do we protect ourselves? And so you're seeing legislation pop up. Can you use hiring decision-making software to figure out whose resume you're going to look at and hire? You're seeing companies like flat out ban AI internally, which best of luck to you. It's probably not going to work out super well. And I'm here to tell you that we can't legislate the bias away. We can't engineer the bias away, said the engineer. It's not going to happen, right? Because it's trained on your perspectives, your thoughts and ideas, and mine. We have different perspectives, and we bring different biases to the table. It's trained on the internet, which, as it turns out, has a lot of biases and perspectives and opinions in it. So it's not going to go away. What will happen, not immediately, it's going to take a while, but will happen is there will be some legislation that gets put into place to put some controls in. There will be frameworks that the industry starts to pick up as best practices for developing safe, responsible AI that's going to be careful about your data privacy. So those things are going to happen, but I don't think they're going to happen fast enough for our adoption and for the speed at which AI is emerging and showing up in our space. So this is where you all come in. As consumers of AI, this is where I want to tap into the informed consumer in you, the critical consumer that has demands. The market right now, all software out there, is under tremendous pressure to get that little magic, write it for me, draw it for me, create it for me button, the little wand, the little sparkles. And so there's this big pressure, and all these companies are like, okay, I'm gonna get it in there, it's gonna be fine, I'm gonna tell my CEO, and they're doing it, they're buying some off-the-shelf AI, and they're plugging it into that text box, and it's actually really kind of easy. And so we are suddenly faced with all of these do the thing for me buttons, but we don't know what's underneath that button. They kind of look similar. So how do we know if we can trust that? What's the option here? We have to start asking questions, and it's going to be heavily on the consumer to push these conversations and ask for the information we need to be able to trust it. So the things that we tend to see is like when bias is kind of in your face, when the problematic stuff is in your face and it's really obvious. And so then we don't really need to ask the question. We know there's a problem there. But more often than not, it's actually really subtle. And I want to give you a real world example of what that subtlety is and what it looks like, because it's so hard to see, and so it's going to make us hard to look out for it and ask the right questions. So bias in AI, it's not subjective. It's math, right? You ask the AI to do something for you, and you can then change one little thing about what you've asked it, and you can measure the differences in its responses to you. And that tells you what its tendencies are. So real world example from my world, because that's the stuff I know about. So I'm the CTO for a company. We build AI specifically to see bias, to interrupt bias. We've been doing that for the last 10 years. So that's what our technology does. And one of our focus areas is in performance feedback. And because performance feedback, everybody hates doing it, it's exhausting, it's time consuming. So people turn to ChatGPT to write performance feedback for the people they manage. This is kind of scary, actually. We want to do an experiment. So we asked ChatGPT to write performance feedback for a marketer, constructive feedback for this marketer. We had to do it hundreds of times. And in one case, we said this person had graduated from Howard University. In another case, we said Harvard University. And then we analyzed the results. And they're pretty upsetting. ChatGPT has some strong opinions here. The person that graduated from Howard University, they're hard to get along with. They're missing technical skills. They're lacking the attention to detail. The Harvard grad, well, they should step up and be a leader more. They're condescending and micromanaging, but yeah, go ahead, lead more. Now, going back to the real world application of this, and you imagine this AI in your HR software, in your performance feedback software, that's going to go down on your permanent record. And that's going to have impact on your career trajectory. So it's kind of a big deal. And if you looked at it just by itself, if you asked AI just once, give me this constructive feedback for this person just once, you might not have seen it. It's when we look at the differences, And not everybody's got time to go ask ChatGPT to do this hundreds of times and then analyze the results. So this stuff can actually be really subtle. So what do? You become the informed consumer. You demand the assurances. Start looking. When you're going to go and buy software, if it's for your company, for yourself, you have to look behind the software itself and the shiny buttons and see, like, okay, can I trust this? Are they advertising on their website what they're doing with responsible AI development? Are they talking about it at all? Are they telling you if it's their AI or something off the shelf that they bought? If you can look for signals to let you know if the software has something in it that you can trust or not. Now, I'm not here to say don't use AI. I want you to. It's amazing. It's incredible what it's going to be able to do for us. I get to work at a company that's building AI to disrupt bias. I am one of 8.3% of CTOs in America that are women. And my company is building AI to fix that frustrating stat. So I'm a big fan. Like, I think it can do fantastic things, and it's going to take you and your pressure as consumers to change this, because we can't wait for legislation, and we can't trust all the makers of the AI, of the technology, to put in those safeguards. When you go and have a choice between two software options, and you buy the one that's saying, hey, you can trust us, and here's the reasons why, instead of the one that's not, the one that's not is going to figure that out, like, oh man, we just lost that sale. Because we're not doing the right thing. And so your buying choice, your buying power is actually going to influence how we build AI way faster than trusting legislation and us who are responsible for making the AI. So go put pressure on us. Make us do a good job so we don't mess it up.
All right. Well done.